Yeah, you know what? That's what happens when you get good deals, right?
I guess so. Well, then he could just mount it on the wall if he got some room.
That's true.
See, there you go.
Possibilities.
Have your boyfriend do a project when you go. We started off this morning with some nice and quiet weather, but as we get into the afternoon and evening, we're going to notice clouds increasing, and it's ahead of our storm system tomorrow, an area of low pressure right now tracking across the Rockies. And you see a lot of the cloud cover and some of the Rocky Mountain snows associated with it. High pressure still in control over the eastern part of the country, but this is going to slide eastward. That's going to allow this storm to move in here. We've got a lot of winter weather advisories, warnings, even a blizzard warning in Iowa. It is the strong winds on the backside that are going to usher in some very chilly air behind the storm. A lot of the Wisconsin state under a winter storm watch ahead of our system. Here at home, everyone's under a winter storm watch. This is the first one of the season. We had to wait until now, the last month of winter, in order to pick that up. But it doesn't mean the snowfall ends at the end of February, just we start to gradually warm things up. So what we're expecting is if we get into tomorrow morning, especially in the early morning hours, could have a little wintry mix, some sleet, freezing rain, rain, snow mix, but then more cold air will start to wrap around into the system, and any wintry mix will quickly transition over to snowfall. We'll be coming down heavily at times. Winds initially will be coming in out of the southeast, so lakeside areas, probably you're going to be limited with the amount of snowfall, but then once the winds shift out of the west, then everyone should be dealing with the snow, including the lakeshore areas. Right now, I do anticipate some hazardous traveling, and also accumulations will vary depending on where you live. I'll show the maps in a moment. So increasing clouds as we get into the afternoon, then turning overcast overnight tonight. As we get into the late overnight, starting to see slight chance of a wintry mix, but the main ingredients don't arrive here until probably the mid to late morning hours tomorrow. You're seeing the bulk of the snowfall moving in by about lunchtime, carrying over into the afternoon and evening hours, and then it starts to lift out of here as you get into late tomorrow night. Some of the computer model data is suggesting this lingering into Friday morning before we start to see some clearing skies on the backside. Accumulation wise, this is just a little graph I made showing the different computer models ranging from about 4 to 7 inches across the Fox Valley. But there are some other locations, especially up into the Northwoods, that could be seeing higher totals than that, especially upwards of 8 to 9 inches into the Northwoods. So that's great news for all of you snowmobilers out there who want to get those trails open. Lakeside areas, a little bit limited because of that initial southeast wind flow, so that's going to keep your totals just down, but it's going to be a wet and heavy snow, so probably the snow blower and the snow shovel will likely be needed as we start to clean things up. Behind it, cold air starts to surge in here, and we're talking about the coldest air so far this season to arrive. It's 10 degrees right now in Green Bay with winds out of the west at 5 miles per hour. We're holding on into pretty much chilly weather across the entire viewing area, so grab a jacket as you head out the door. We'll climb up to high right around 32 today with winds out of the southeast at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Tonight we'll drop down to 27 southeast at 5 to 15. We got another day of 30s, but afterwards we get a nice good taste of some nice cold winter weather that we normally tend to see. There's always one time in the year that we get these cold temperatures, Abby, and it looks like it's finally arriving.
No thanks. All right, thanks, Gino. Yeah. Well,